My name's Kevin Robinson, and I work at the MIT Teaching Systems Lab, working on game design for teacher education, and then product design and software engineering. My background has gone through a few different paths. I worked as a special education teacher. I worked doing technology projects with school districts, and then transitioned to working as a software engineer. I used design thinking when I was a special education teacher all the time. Special education is about serving students in unique ways and creating new, more effective interventions for than is used in general education. So sort of by definition, you don't know the answer of how to best serve those students, and so it's really important to come up with a lot of different possible solutions, try them out, and then keep improving them to see what works with your students. When I worked in industry as a software engineer, I mostly used design thinking in creating new product experiences. So a product I worked on was helping people understand how users used their apps. And so we would make a lot of different visualizations and a lot of different representations of that information, and then show them all to users and let them see. Within TSL, we use the design process for all of our work and research. So the imagination stage is really important, especially when we're trying to come up with new ways to help prepare teachers. Often what we'll do is we'll come up with some idea of something we want to help teachers improve at. Let's say it's doing the inquiry process in science classrooms, trying to get students more engaged with asking questions and doing modeling and other parts of the scientific process. When we start, we know that's kind of the direction we want to go in, but there's so many possibilities of what the teacher could improve at, what skill we'll teach them, what kind of game mechanics we could use in the process to help them experience that, and then sort of how learning occurs. Is it through discussion? Is it through reflection? Is it through practice? What kind of modalities? And so what we'll do is we'll basically try to explore all of those things as early as possible and let those ideas, even though we're not quite sure how they'd work, but we'd say, well, what if we focus on this aspect of teaching students to ask questions? And what if we use this particular style of game to do that? And then see what happens after that. Often you want to spend a bunch of time up front ideating. You want to be thinking of all the possible ways we could create this new game for teachers. But you know that you also have to create that and test it. So when it gets to be Wednesday and you're still in ideation, everybody feels really like, oh, like we kind of got to get this done and move on. So I think planning that out up front and having a sort of shared idea of how long you can spend ideating is important. But it roughly only takes like a fifth of the process. It depends, too, if you're doing something that's really new and people in your group really don't know how to do it. Spending more time in ideation can be really powerful, especially if you're trying to do something more risky or ambitious. So the design process is always conceived of as a cycle. And when you're doing the design process in practice, you only have usually one or two passes through that cycle before you have to show something to someone. And so having bounds for each step of the process is really important. When you're doing something that's new and you don't have a lot of expertise, or maybe no one in the world has a lot of expertise on how to solve the problems you're trying to solve, spending a lot of ideation can be really important. But you want to be careful that you don't spend all of your time doing that. So the best way to manage this for any design process is to have deadlines and to have time bounds. So often a week or a month or some other sort of natural boundary is really helpful. And even better is if you have someone who's a real audience or a real user or a real person who's going to benefit from the work that you're doing at the end of the time. So if you're doing a week design process and you spend Monday coming up with all these great ideas, everyone in the group has that pressure in the back of their head of, well, we're going to have to deliver on some of this by Friday to this person who's going to try it out. And so that helps move things along.